वेलकम टू यू ऑल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मेडिसिन डिपार्टमेंट बसुंधरा आर्दिन मेडिकल कॉलेज हॉस्पिटल आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर संजीव कुमार शाह टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट निमोनिया वी नो दैट निमोनिया इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट इन आवर एग्जाम आवर बोर्ड बाइबा लॉन्ग केस शॉर्ट केस दिस केस इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल एंड हाउ कैन वी इंटरप्रिट एंड manage this case. First of all, we know that clinically we found four types of pneumonia: community acquired pneumonia, hospital acquired pneumonia, pneumonia in immunocompromised patient, and aspiration pneumonia. In our clinical practice, community acquired pneumonia is very much common. The organism are Streptococcus pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenza, Moraxella catarrhalis. Some another organism causes atypical pneumonia. It may be the bacteria, wireless bacteria like Mycoplasma, Chlamydia, Rhizoonella, and also some viruses. So what are the basic difference between the typical and atypical organism causing pneumonia? We know that pneumonia affects the lung. So when typical organism causes pain, first of all fever, chest pain, initially non-productive cough, later on productive and rusty colored sputum, and chest pain means pleurisy, followed by chest pain will be disappear when pleural effusion come. So in a nutshell, when we discuss the pneumonia, first of all patient complaints as fever, high rise fever, intermittent in nature, chest pain, followed by disappear of chest pain when development of pleural effusion, cough, initially dry cough, later on productive cough, it may be rusty color, and when effusion is greater then or complication occurs, then breathlessness develop. This is the typical features of typical organism. But when we think atypical organism pneumonia, that says a symptom may be subacute onset, fever may not be present, cough usually dry, and the sign symptom of pneumonia may be absent, only for clinical suspicion. We know for clinically, when we examine the patient, we divide two types pneumonia. This is novel pneumonia and bronchopneumonia. In typical organism causes lobar pneumonia, which affects a particular lobe of the lungs, and bronchopneumonia, this is atypical organism, involves maybe both sides of the lung, there be no maintain the particular loop. On auscultation or examination of the chest, we found that their chest movement may be restricted in the affected side, as because in early stage of pleurisy. Second thing, buccal fremitus will be increasing in affected side. We know that pneumonia means the spongy lung structure will turn to solid tissue. The spongy lung structure will turn to solid tissue. So when we examine the lobar pneumonic patient, then we found the movement is restricted in affected side, buccal fremitus will be increased, and chest expansibility will be reduced, percussion will be dull. It is woody dull usually, but sometimes it cannot be differentiated when it associated with pleural effusion. So only dull is in exam you say only dull, it is the safe side, but you should remember that woody dull occurs in only pneumonia, but stony dull occur in pleural effusion, which I have already discussed you the earlier classes of pleural effusion. We know the breath sound is usually vesicular, but in case of pneumonic consolidation the breath sound will be bronchial, high pitch sound in gap in two equal phase, inspiration and expiration, the bronchial. We know that normal bronchial breath sound may be heard in our over the trachea. So in and vocal resonance will be high, vocal resonance will be increase. In our exam, in bedside clinics, bedside long case or short case, examiner frequently asks you the question, what are the positive findings in favor of diagnosis of pneumonia? So first of all, you should inspection movement is restricted, movement will be restricted, and vocal parameters will be high, and percussion note will be woody dull, bass sound will be bronchial, and increase vocal resonance. You should mention the affected side. It may be right side or left side, and along intercostal space. It may be the mid clavicular, along the mid clavicular line, or mid axillary line, or the dorsal scapular line. Where so you should always mention the pathology involved that side. It should be mentioned, and other unaffected side will be everything will be normal. But in case of bronchopneumonia, which I already told you, the atypical organism causes bronchopneumonia, but no findings usually found, only for few some crepitation may be found, and bass sound may be vesicular, and these are the clinical findings of pneumonia. In that cases, how can we evaluate the patient for management? Before management, we have a scoring system. First of all, CARB 65 scoring system. This scoring system help us, patient should be managed as outpatient or short stay, inpatient or indoor hospitalization. No, if patient suffering from pneumonia, no need to hospitalization. We assess prognosis and assessment required for CARB 65 scoring. CARB mean confusion, C mean confusion, U mean urea level more than 7, respiratory rate more than 30, blood pressure, systolic blood pressure less than 90, as age 65. These five parameters help you how you manage this patient. If only for one score, so no need hospitalization, only home management, but it is two or more, then short stay inpatient, indoor treatment, or three or more, we can admit the patient in hospitalized and treat as a complicated pneumonia. So we have to know what are the complications of pneumonia. The most common complication of pneumonia is paraneumonic effusion. Another complication of lung abscess, pulmonary embolism, pneumothorax, the septicemia involved in multiple organ, so it turns to multi-organ failure, including meningitis, ARDS, acute renal failure, and etc. So these are the complications of pneumonia. How will you investigate this patient? When we suspect the patient a case of pneumonia, we first advise patient for chest X-ray. Chest X-ray, posterior view or lateral decubitus view, as because lateral decubitus view or oblique view. Chest X-ray, posterior view showing the anterior segment or lobe of the lung, and lateral decubitus view will find you the minimal pleural effusion, and oblique view involve the oblique fissure and identify the lobe, upper lobe or lower lobe or horizontal lobe, horizontal fissure. This can help you the diagnosis. We know that at least 300 ml fluid is required to detect radiologically for pleural effusion detection. So chest X-ray is mandatory. So what will be the findings of chest X-ray? We know that in case of pneumonic consolidation, spongy lung structure is turns to solid structure. So in that cases, we found in chest X-ray heterogeneous opacity. Heterogeneous opacity involving lobe. It may be lower lobe, upper lobe. So we know that in right side of the lung there will be three lobe, divided by two fissure. One is horizontal fissure, another is oblique fissure. So this is horizontal fissure is divided by upper and middle lobe, oblique fissure divided by middle and lower lobe, but in case of left side is only for two lobe. So in case of chest X-ray we found heterogeneous opacity, as because air bronchogram is present here. In case of pneumonia, it is the disease of lung parenchyma, not for bronchus. So the bronchus will be patent and air will be there. So this is the heterogeneous opacity and with air bronchogram. So how can we differentiate from mass lesion to pneumonic consolidation in chest X-ray? It is very much important. As you know, in our viva exam, pneumonic consolidation or any consolidation X-ray is usually given, and exam will be started, but exam will be started this X-ray. You can differentiate it by air bronchogram, but in cases mass lesion, it will be homogeneous consolidation. Homogeneous, homo means only for whitening color, but hetero means black and white color. It indicates air patency is maintained. It is called air bronchogram. When you say this is heterogeneous opacity, it is this consolidation is pneumonic, as because bronchus is patent here. But when you see there is homogeneous opacity, no air, it is maybe mass lesion, probably bronchial carcinoma, and pathogenesis origin from in bronchus. So distal portion is obliterated, no air is passed, and appearing as a consolidation, homogeneous consolidation. These are the findings. But in case of bronchopneumonia, in both lung field there be patchy opacity, no definitive loop maintained. You should keep in your mind that in case of lower pneumonia, there's a particular loop will be maintained, but in case of mass lesion, there will be no particular loop. It may be involved in upper loop or middle loop or involved in between two loop. It is a malignancy or any tumor. But in case of patchy bronchopneumonia, either both lung field may be equally effective and it will be patchy, hilar to periphery. Clinically, we differentiated lower pneumonia and bronchopneumonia, I already said. First of all, organism can causes the, these are the three common organisms: Streptococcus pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenzae, and Moraxella catarrhalis. Other bacteria, atypical bacteria, they have no wall. These are the Mycoplasma, Chlamydia, Legionella, some viruses which may cause the atypical organism. So how can we investigate this case? First of all, chest X-ray and findings I discuss you. Then CBC. Well, how, what information we found from complete blood count? Total count will be high, it will be leukocytosis, ESR will be raised. So peripheral blood pressure increase, neutrophilic leukocytosis. But in case of atypical organism affected causing the bronchopneumonia, this will be leukopenia. Leukopenia. Second thing, we have to send blood culture. Blood culture for find out the organism. Blood culture usually positive for lower pneumonia. But in case of atypical organism, we have to do some special investigation. In case of mycoplasma pneumonia, we can do cold agglutination test. In case of Legionella urinary antigen, this special investigation is done, but there is a limited facility is available, especially in Bardem, ICT-DRB, other hospital may do this investigation. Other investigation we suggest to see the complication, as because we know that pneumonia not only for limited to the lung, it may affects the multi system. So we can do the blood electrolytes, liver function test, renal function test, even CT scan or MRI of brain. So it is necessary to find out the complication. How can we manage this pneumonia? Usually in our curriculum, we actually discuss here for community acquired pneumonia. First of all, if uncomplicated pneumonia and complicated pneumonia, we can divide by two types, complicated and uncomplicated pneumonia. In case of uncomplicated pneumonia, CARB 65 scoring system is 1. Then we give only for amoxicillin 500 milligram, etoly for 7 to 10 days. If patient is allergic to amoxicillin or penicillin group drug, then we can introduce erythromycin 500 milligram, 6 only, or clarithromycin 500 milligram, 12 only. But in case of complicated pneumonia, we started injectable antibiotic, as well if patient is hypoxic, we give oxygen therapy. So patient have to hospitalize where? In his general ward or SDU or ICU. So patient should be hospitalized at least SDU, high dependency unit, or in ICU if saturation is falling vigorously. Usually we started injectable antibiotic, one group from penicillin, it may be ceftriaxone or coamoxiclav. Second thing, one from macrolide group drug, it may be clarithromycin or azithromycin. Plus another group, if any abscess occur, we can add fluclocoxacillin. So these are the antibiotic regime for community acquired pneumonia in case of complicated pneumonia treating this. When there be another some complication occurs, like we should correction of electrolyte imbalance, and in case of high creatinine level, it may transaneuria or acute renal failure, short term dialysis may be done. Along with some chest complication is occurs, so pleural effusion, pleural fluid should be drained. In case of empyema thoracis complicated by infection of pleural fluid, then case of chest tube drain should be done. In case of pneumothorax, it not very common, but may occurs in association with pneumonia, and that time chest tube drain should be given. So these are the treatment protocol of complicated and uncomplicated community acquired pneumonia along with management of complication. Another thing is hospital acquired pneumonia. What is the definition of hospital acquired pneumonia? When patient hospitalized and within 2 days of hospitalization pneumonia develops, then it is called hospital acquired pneumonia. There are some multiple factor in developing hospital acquired pneumonia. These are the post-operative care, achalasia cardia, some immunosuppressive drug, steroid, etc., etc. So in that cases, the organism will be gram-negative organism, E. coli, Klebsiella, and Staph aureus. These are the very culprit agent, Staph aureus, including methicillin resistant staph aureus and anaerobes. Tale in case of exam we frequently ask you question, what are the organism in hospital acquired pneumonia? You will say the three types of organism. First of gram negative, second staph aureus MRSA group, third is anaerobe organism. So we can start this regime according to suspicion. We know that we cannot wait starting antibiotic. We start antibiotic according to patient history and clinical scenario. Is it community acquired pneumonia? Then we start antibiotic according to empirical therapy. Susceptibility of organism, what will be the organism, including sputum culture. One thing I am missing, you should send also sputum for gram stain and culture sensitivity test. It is helpful to us. But in case of hospital acquired pneumonia, we started gram negative organism covering antibiotic, including anaerobes, metronidazole. Second thing, when a patient is receiving chemotherapy or any immunosuppressed condition, that time patient suffering from pneumonia, it may occur in your home or hospital. So it is called pneumonia in immunocompromised patient. And that cases anaerobic organism, gram negative organism, including fungal infection is very much common. So when we treating this pneumonia in immunocompromised patient, we started broad spectrum gram negative covering antibiotic including metronidazole in along with injectable antifungal drug. So history is very much important. Last of all, we frequently drill in our ward, or it is aspiration pneumonia. Patient may admit stroke, but when patient suffering from suddenly aspiration, it very much difficult to treat this patient. In that cases, we also give antibiotic. Empirically, gram negative injectable along with anaerobes covering antibiotic metronidazole, oxygen supplementation and chest physiotherapy. What are the, but we giving treatment, but why not responding pneumonia? What are the factors that not responding to treatment? There are several factors in pneumonic patient not responding to treatment. These are the incorrect microbiological diagnosis. This is very much important. If a patient suffering from community acquired pneumonia, chest X-ray showing lower consolidation or chest X-ray showing patchy opacity, history suggestive of community acquired pneumonia, then we started gram positive organism and macrolide group antibiotic. This will be coamoxiclav or ceftriaxone including erythromycin or clarithromycin, or tar sathe including this if there is a abscess, flucloxacillin. But when you think it is aspiration pneumonia, you should empirically started gram negative covering antibiotic. These may be ceftazidime or meropenem including anaerobes covering antibiotic. These will be metronidazole. So before starting empirical antibiotic, you should take meticulously history from the patient attendant, at least seeing the chest X-ray. If your chest X-ray could not give you the clue, you can do CT scan. So empirical antibiotic is very much important initiation of starting patient treating pneumonia. Second thing, ineffective dose. So first of all, we give, why not responding, incorrect microbiological diagnosis. Second, inefficient dose of the antibiotic. So we should maintain the dose, antibiotic proper dose. Dose reduction is usually required in patient have other comorbidity like renal compromise or background history of acute renal insult or chronic renal failure. Second thing, underlying some pathology. This may be obstruction. We know that recurrent pneumonia is another causes of underlying bronchial adenoma or carcinoma. If patient suffering from bronchial obstruction, that case is secondary pneumonia, secondary infection may present with pneumonia. In that case, pneumonia will be partially response. Fourth thing, patient non-compliance. We treating this patient at home, patient do not take this drug and or take inefficient drug and pneumonia will not be resolved. So, in our Viva question, we ask you the factor causes or affecting not responding to treatment of pneumonia. There are four factors. First of all, incorrect microbiological diagnosis. Second, thinking ineffective dose duration of antibiotic. We know that in case of complicated pneumonia, antibiotic should be given at least 14 days injectable antibiotic, but when it complicated occurs by lung abscess, it should be drained and it may be extend up to 4 weeks. So, dose and duration should be maintained. Third thing, underlying cause may be tuberculosis or bronchial carcinoma. Fourth thing, patient non-compliance. Very important in our exam. Last of all, what are the causes of recurrent pneumonia? It is frequently asked in our Viva board, what are the causes of recurrent pneumonia? First of all, when patient have underlying structural lung disease, these are the bronchial carcinoma, bronchial adenoma or bronchiectasis, these are the causes which may predispose to development of pneumonia. Second thinking, patient is immunocompromised state, he is poorly controlled diabetes, received chemotherapy agent repeatedly or in the course of cycle, so any pregnancy and IV drug abuser, so these are the causes of recurrent pneumonia. Hope you will enjoy this class. If any question, then we will discuss the later class. Thank you.